You've calculated averages before. To get each student's average from this list of exam scores, you'd add all the subject scores together and divide that by the total number of subjects. The technical term for that is the arithmetic mean, and we can do that in Excel by typing an equal sign, the word average, open parenthesis, and the range where your numbers can be found. When you close parentheses, then your average will be displayed. We can even type those numbers right inside the parentheses to get the average of any group of numbers. So let's say we wanted the average of these three numbers. We'd have it right here. Let's copy these averages for all our students. But now let's take a closer look at these numbers. Student E didn't take the accounts exam because they were sick, so they weren't scored at all. Student E's average was calculated based on the numbers from the other subject scores. See, when we highlight these values, this value in the status bar rounded to 80.2 matches this value here, even though our range included cell B8. Was that fair? Well, some teachers don't think so. They want to account for the fact that there should be another score in B8. In that case, we should be using the average A function. The format of the average A is the same, but it takes into account all cells within the specified range, even if that cell contains text. So let's get our average A for each student. Remember, the format is the same, so we just need to get the range. We can double-click on the fill handle, and we see the difference for student E. The average is 80.2, but with average A, it's 68.7. It assigns a value of 0 to the text in B8. The only text that's not assigned a value of 0 is the word true, because it's considered a logical value, and it's given a value of 1. So the average A is slightly more. But this student was sick, so they got a score of 0 for accounts, and now their total is divided by 7 subjects instead of the 6 subjects they actually sat the exams for. Now if we put nothing in this cell, then the average A treats it as no value, and we'd get the same result as the average formula. Well, we're still looking at our scores, and we've just looked at another set. We've seen that for student J, they got 0 on their art exam, and we feel like 68% isn't a real reflection of that student's abilities, so we want to exclude that art score from their average. We can manually select the scores that we want to include by using the average function and just pressing the Control or Command key on our keyboard to select the cells that we do want. So we hold down the Control key to select non-adjacent cells. We close parentheses as usual. Take a look at the formula bar. It separates both sets of ranges. And we hit Enter. And now, this is our average, removing that 0 value. Alternatively, the AVERAGEIF function can take care of that by allowing us to state a condition for the values that we want to include or exclude. Here we want to include only those values not equal to 0. And this is how we represent that. We select our range as usual, and now we need our criteria. Double quotes. Less than, greater than means not equal to. 0. Double quotes. And our average range, that's the third argument, it's in square brackets, so that's optional. We don't need to include that because the range that we want to find the average of is the same range that we selected in argument A. So we close parentheses and hit enter. Let's see if we get the same 79.8 with using the average if as we did when we calculated this manually. We double click. And we do. We also see a difference in student E's scores between the average if and the average A because we're removing those sick and 0 values from our average. Sometimes the arithmetic mean allows very high or very low numbers to sway the outcome, as we've seen in some of these examples. So there's another type of mean that we may be interested in, and that's the median, or the middle number in a group of numbers. Of course, this is Excel, so there's a function for that, and it's called the median function. What it does is that in the background, this function counts the number of values in the group and determines the order, whether ascending or descending, and then selects the middle number as the median. Let's do that now. Let's select our range here. We close parentheses. And it says our median is 83. What Excel did was to find the middle number. Well, there are 7 numbers in this range. The middle number would be the 4th one. If we put them in ascending order, 69 would be the first, then we have the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. 83 would be the middle score, which is what our median calculated. If it's an odd number of values, then the middle number is obvious, but if it's an even number, the median is calculated as the average of the 2 numbers in the middle. So let's say there's no math score. Now we have 6 subjects. What would be the middle? The middle number would be somewhere between the 3rd and 4th numbers. So this is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and this is the 4th. So our middle number is somewhere between these two. We'd find the average of these 2 numbers to get the median, and that would be 84, which is exactly what Excel got in the median function. So we're happy with the median function. Let's copy to the remaining students. And finally, maybe you decide that finding the mode is the way to go. The mode tells us which number occurs most frequently in our distribution. If there aren't any duplicate values, we'll get an NA result. So let's find the mode for each student. We select our range, and Excel will tell us which number occurs most frequently for each student. We have 4 cells with an NA value because there were no duplicate scores for these students. So did you know there were so many ways to find the average? Learn even more statistical functions from our Excel library at GoSkills.com.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.